everyone, welcome to We Knew the Moon. My name's Tracy and I'm here with Dee.
Hi.
Today we are going to be talking about the waning gibbous moon phase. This is the sixth phase in the moon cycle. So for those of you that have been following us up until this point, we've released podcasts on all of the different phases of the moon cycle, starting at new moon and following it all the way through. And this phase, waning gibbous, Dee loves the word gibbous, don't you, Dee?
I love the word gibbous.
It's following right after full moon. So we've had lovely full moon where you've done all of your lovely rituals. Waning means smaller. Gibbous means what, Dee? Engorged?
Bulbous.
Bulbous. Engorged.
Engorged. Also the same.
Yeah, similar. So, you know, it's still very much, it looks very similar to a full moon. There's just a little sliver off there. We're not really supposed to be doing much at all. Up until full moon, we've been working hard, completing our intentions, doing that to-do list. We've reached full moon where we've stopped, paused, given thanks, reflected on everything that we've done. And things don't pick up again after here, Dee. Like, we just carry on reflecting, pausing, slowing down. The moon's energy is decreasing. And with that, our energy decreases as well. So it's like winding down after a busy day. So the key words for this phase are gratitude. You're reaping in the rewards of everything you've done. From new moon, you've been working hard, you've been doing your to-do list, hopefully earning money or ticking off all those things that you wanted to do. And now, during the waning gibbous phase, you are reaping in all of the rewards of everything that you've done. It's a good phase, isn't it? It's a really nice phase. Be careful, though, because you can find yourself during this time going a little bit extreme in the spending and buying stuff that you might not necessarily need. If you're not the kind of person that is money focused, or maybe you perhaps haven't earned lots of money because that wasn't your intentions in your moon intentions that you set for new moon, write a list of things that you're grateful for in life, your gratitude. That could be your friends, it could be your family, it could be your home, it could be things you own, it could be your health. There's so many things that we don't give thanks for that we just take advantage of and presume that are always going to be there. This phase, I think, is a really good one to just sit, make a list of everything you give thanks for and give back. So if you're thankful for your friends being in your life, give back to them and arrange a time to meet up with them and tell them how grateful you are of having them in your life. If you're grateful for your home, give back in some way. It's not just about reaping in those rewards, but it's also giving out and sharing as well. Dee, you'll love this bit as well. Waning gibbous is a massive time for self-care. You've been working really hard from full moon now into this phase and the ones that follow. They can all be a little bit fuzzy because they're very reflective and we have keywords like forgiveness and gratitude, release, and not really much about manifesting or setting goals or doing. It's more about reflecting. It's important that you take this time to really restock, refuel and look after yourself. So, you know, make sure maybe you have a few early nights, go to a spa. I know Dee likes to have her spa care. I like my baths. Invest in some vitamins, paint your nails, which you might not have had time to do. And again, we always say it's not practical that you can just stop working. We all have jobs and we all have to carry on. Also, just rein it back a little bit and try and rest and look after yourself. And if you do that right, then you'll be ready for hopefully the next phases to come. That's waning gibbous. That's definitely this phase of just nurture and look after yourself and do those little treats.
What I'm understanding from you is to have a nice pampery morning and then go out for brunch with your friends to tell them how much you love them.
Yes. It's a good phase, right, Dee? Like, it's not a bad one, is it? Okay, so I hope that summarised waning gibbous moon phase for everyone. I think the key words here are gratitude, sharing, indulgence. It's the Christmas phase of the moon cycle. That's how I would describe it. Would you think, Dee?
That's a lovely way to describe it.
Yeah.
I'm getting really excited about the next waning gibbous.
Yeah. So we always said that the smaller phases of the moon cycle were always going to be mini moons. But as always, Dee, I found more to add about the moon, which I wanted to just talk to everyone about because it's something that I've always skipped over. So there is such a thing as the north and south nodes. Astrology can be quite scary and overwhelming. Like, there's a lot of mathematical calculations that go into it, and you know, it's always, when you're reading about it, it's on a flat bit of paper and you're trying to figure it in 3D. For anyone that's looked at their natal chart, we talked about finding your moon signs and simplified it. But if you look at your full natal chart, it's beneathemoon.co.uk. You can find out all of your different planet signs for when you were born. You go into it deeper, it's almost like there's a step, and it's a big step, and it gets very complicated. There's loads of different layers to it. I just wanted to talk about the north and south node because I feel like it's really significant. The sun, the earth, and the moon are all very significant planetary bodies that affect us, and their position in the zodiac constellations, which we talked about before. If you haven't, have a listen to our previous episodes. They have significant effects on aspects of our personality, and these planetary bodies, they move constantly into these different signs, and their positions relating to each other are very much what the north node and the south node refer to. We know that the moon orbits the earth and it has a kind of oval axis, so it's going round the earth, and at certain points on this axis, so the sun is moving through the zodiac constellations because it is moving through the signs. It's stationary, and scientists will probably be saying, no, it doesn't move. But it's positioned in accordance to the zodiac constellations. It does change. For everyone that's born in a certain month, like I'm a Taurus, the sun's position in the constellation was in Taurus. If you imagine that movement of the sun and the movement of the moon at two points, they are on the same path. Their axis, their orbit, their circle crosses. One north above the earth and one south below the earth. Your north node and your south node.
Is that a specific time of year when the moon and the sun line up? Or is it different for each person depending on when you were born?
So the north node and the south node, they change zodiac sign every 18 months. So slow movers. These points are in a zodiac for a specific time. It doesn't matter when the moon is in that node or the sun's in that node. It's where that position of that node is.
Gotcha, yeah.
So it's that exact mathematically calculated point of the north and the south. And where that point is in the zodiac is the north node and the south node.
So can I just ask? So, for example, you and I, are we only a month apart? Born a month apart.
We are, yeah. Born a month apart, but a year apart.
Oh, well. Right. Okay, sorry. But chances are we possibly we have the same nodes then?
We do have the same nodes. I looked them up.
Oh, I'm sorry.
So, yeah. You can look them up on our website. If you want to find out what your north node zodiac sign is when you were born, visit our website. So for us, Dee, and it must have been a close change because it's every 18 months. So we are on the same north node and the same south node. I want to tell you what they mean though first, and then maybe have a guess of what they are. Because we've discussed about the planet. We talked about Mars being our energy and drive. We talked about Venus being love, Mercury the mind. So the nodes symbolize our fate, our destiny, our path in life. And the north node is our path forwards. And our south node is our path backwards. I don't want to offend people with religious beliefs, but a lot of spirituality involves a soul's journey. And a lot of people believe that our soul has been here more than once. The south node was your soul's beginning. It's how it started on its journey through life. And your north node is who you are moving towards to be. I like to imagine it as a road. So south node is karmic past life, patterns, things that we've done, things that we need to learn from. North node is growth, moving forwards, our fate, our future, opportunities, life purpose and fulfillment. And the interesting thing is these nodes kind of go backwards. So we're very used to the zodiac wheel starting at Aries and finishing at Pisces, and we go through them. This constellation, because it goes anti-clockwise, we're going backwards through the signs. Your north node will always be the very opposite sign to your south node. We start at Aries, there's 12 of them. We transition through to Taurus, Gemini, Cancer. We finish at Pisces. Each sign has an opposite on that wheel. With the North and South nodes, they are always the opposite. So imagine them on that wheel. I did have a look at mine and Dee's North and South node signs. Would you like to have a guess at what our South node is, Dee? What sign or zodiac it was? At the start of
Can you
our...
give me some characteristics?
So it's a traveling sign. It likes a lot of adventure.
Sagittarius?
Yeah, Sagittarius.
Is it?
Yeah. In our past lives, maybe, or at the start of this soul's journey, and we were travelers, but we're moving away from that because that's our south node, so that's mm-hmm. our past. Our soul is going on this journey towards our north node. Which, can you have a guess what our north node is? No. It's very chatty, likes to communicate, likes to share things, likes to gather information.
Gemini?
Gemini, yeah.
Oh, how interesting.
It is, isn't it? If you think about what we're doing now, like we're rooted, we're grounded, we're trying to share information with people, we're gathering mm-hmm. stuff.
We're talking a lot.
We are talking a lot. So I thought it was really, really interesting, the North and South nodes.
Oh, thank you so much for explaining that.
The moon has this orbit and it goes anti-clockwise, rounds backwards through these signs, through the North and South nodes. When it's heading up towards the north node, it's called the dragon's head. So when it's going towards north, it's called dragon's head. And when it's going back down, it's called the dragon's tail. And I was like, ooh, dragon.
That's super cute.
Interesting. The reason that it's had this very old name of the dragon's head and the dragon's tail is because people wrote about eclipses. There's lots of text and transcript. People feared. I mean, could you imagine the horror of like an eclipse? It goes really dark. People thought that a dragon had swallowed the sun or the moon. So this whole kind of idea of the moon's orbit of going down towards the south and up towards the north is the dragon's head and the dragon's tail.
On our website, it's actually really cool, isn't it? Because you can do your birth chart, which will tell you where planets were within the zodiac constellation at the time of your birth. So each of the planets.
If you ever want to figure out yourself, doing your birth chart's a very good breakdown.
Yeah. And there's always more to sort of investigate in it. Like my next step, for example, is that I noticed that all of my outer planetary bodies, the far out ones, were all in retrograde in my birth chart, which I'm hoping isn't too bad. I'm hoping it's not a big deal.
I'm sure it isn't. And that's how it's meant to be for you as well. Like, it wasn't meant to be any other way. Well, hopefully you enjoyed, everyone.
Yeah.
We are learning so much with you all as you listen to this. Our next episode, Dee, is hosting last quarter, mm-hmm. which will be the next phase of the moon following this one. I hope you've enjoyed and see you soon.
Bye.
Bye.
If you enjoyed that and you want more from us, why don't you head over to our Patreon page, patreon.com/WeKnewTheMoon, and check out some bonus content.
Also, if you want to stay up to date, you can follow us on our Facebook page at we.knew.the.moon. If you could leave us a review on our Facebook page, that would mean a lot.
Our Instagram handle is the same as our Facebook, at we.knew.the.moon. We are on Twitter at WeKnewTheMoon1. And we are also on Pinterest. Just search for We Knew the Moon.
Finally, if you want lots more fun, moon info, and all things spiritual, plus our lovely shop, please visit our website, weknewthemoon.co.uk.